Hi, a very good afternoon. This is Abhay from Manu Patra Information Solutions. Thank you for joining us for this webinar to all our attendees. This webinar we are doing on what are the different print options available in Manu Patra for the submissions in court. Okay, so I'm joined by Ms. Soumya Snehal. So she'll be available in chat if you have any questions, if you have any doubts regarding something that we are discussing right now. So she'll be available on chat, so you can drop her message or any questions if you want to ask. So Q&A option is also available, so you can ask that in the Q&A box also. We have planned it to be a more of an interactive session, so a lot of polls are there. I'll be asking a lot of questions, we'll be taking a lot of feedback in this one. So this is how it's going to be. So without further ado, let's start with the first poll. So in 2 minutes you will get poll number one. Okay, so which of the below is not an option available to you to download a judgment in Manu Patra? Okay, we have got 45% people have answered already, so I'll just wait for another 10 seconds before I announce the results. Okay, so let me end the polling now. Share results. Okay, so we have a tie here. So the option most of you have gone with is the PDF in print option and true copy option. Okay, so the correct answer for this one is true copy. So Manu Patra covers PDF and print, print replica and code copy. These are the three options that are available in Manu Patra. True copy is not there. So most of you got it correct in the true copy form. Okay, so let's move on to our next slide, which is what we'll be covering in this session. So in this session, we'll be covering Manu Patra PDF, print replica, code copy, display settings for Manu Patra, display setting for different gadget and notification circulars that are available. I'll also be telling you about in the new normal. So in the pandemic age that we are living right now, how are virtual hearings happening? How are documents being exchanged in the courtroom? Okay, so let's go to Manu Patra now. So I have already made my search. So this is right to information. Let me open my first judgment. Okay, so this is how a judgment in Manu Patra looks like. So this is the equivalent citation. On the left hand side, you will see the Manu Patra citation. Click on that one and you will be able to find the equivalent citations. There are some icons that are available on the left hand side, very, very important icons. We will be not be disturbing these for today. So I'll be covering more of these. This is the judge's name. So all the judge's name is there, even the counsel's name. Everything is hyperlinked. Okay, all the acts that we cover. So in the judgment, all these acts were covered that you can see. So relevant section is also there in terms of, actually this judgment was on section 2 of Right to Information Act. So this is done by my editorial team. My editorial team also puts in the subject. So this is under the category of trust in societies or right to information. So this is under that subject. So again, this is done by my editorial team. Cases referred. These are the list of the cases that were referred in this case. Priority. So this is the prior status. This case actually came from the Kerala High Court judgment. Okay. So that is also linked from here. Everything is cross-referenced, hyperlinked. You can just click onto that button and you will be able to get to that case. Authorities that were referred, citing reference, you can see. So citing reference, where this was mentioned, where this was discussed, all that you will be able to see from here. Okay, so this is for the discussed case note. Any judgment in Manu Patra will have a head note. So you can see from here the case note of the judgment. And this is the body of the judgment. Again, you can see from here. And this is the any section that is mentioned, there is hyperlink to that respective section, or any case law that has been mentioned will also be hyperlinked to that case. Okay. Now I was telling you about how is it happening these days, like how judgments are being presented in the court. So these days, advocates are sharing their screen. Okay, so this is how you are going to do it. So this is, I'm sharing my screen, like right now I'm doing it, you will be doing it in the court. And for any paragraph that you want to highlight to the judge, sir, that way you can just select that particular paragraph. So this way you can highlight this paragraph. Okay, so this is a very small option that is not available in most of the softwares, where you can just pick the whichever paragraph that you want to highlight, that you can do from here. Very simply, whichever paragraph that you want to select, you can just select it from here. Okay, next is, if you want to, there's another option available if you want to highlight a judgment. So this is, I've already done this for you. So this is the 43rd paragraph of the judgment. I have created a sticky note. So this can be done in Manu Patra. So you can, if you want to show this particular judgment in the courtroom, and you can already highlight this. Okay. Now you can take out a printout of this as well with the highlight. And so I'm going to show you how to highlight a paragraph in this judgment, because this is very, very important in the virtual hearing times that we find ourselves in. This is this button. So this is enable sticky note button. Okay, just click onto this one. And then you can see from here that this toolbar appears. From here, you can select whichever paragraph that you want to highlight. So this is this paragraph, paragraph number 6. I can now leave a note on this one. Okay, so I can just select this and select, make a note on this. Say important, and this is important. Okay, so next time anybody opens this judgment or you want to show this in court, so this will be available from here. Okay, so this is how you create sticky notes. You can, if you want to take out a printout of this, that you can do. If you want to take it out without this comment, if you want to take out a printout, that is also possible. Okay. So this is how you highlight a judgment in Manu Patra. If you want to come to the next option, which is the PDF option in Manu Patra. Okay, so this is the next one. This is the PDF Manu Patra. Most of you are Manu Patra users already. This is a very common app option. This has been there for the day one. So this is, you can take out the PDF printout of the judgment. So this is how it looks. And to take out the printout, just go to the judgment, and this is the button that you have to click. Okay, the PDF button in the features section. Now it will ask you whether you want to take it with the headnote or without the headnote. So I'm willing to go with the headnote. So that way you are getting the option to download it without headnote or with headnote, according to your wish, you can do that. So this is how a Manu Patra PDF printout looks like. Okay, Manu Patra branding is there on the top. So this is, we have been there for 20 years, a very recognized authoritative brand. So this is right on the top. The Manu citation is also given on the top of the judgment. Similarly, we also cover more than 340 journals with us. Equivalent journals are available. So equivalent citations from these journals can also be found here. So all the major journals are covered. When you come down, you will see that this is the name of the subscriber will come here. So this is my account. So Abhay Kapkoti is written there. And this is the date in which the printout has been taken. So suppose you are giving this judgment to the Honorable Judge Saab, so he'll know that this judgment has come from you. So this is again very, very important to highlight your name as a subscriber here. This is how a Manu Patra PDF documents looks like. You can download this from here. You can take out a printout of this from here. So anywhere it's required, that you can do. Okay, so this is the PDF option. Coming to the next one that we have is the print replica option. Now, Manu Patra also provides you more than 3 lakh judgments, you will be able to find this scanned replica copy of the judgment. Okay. Now, how is it helpful? Okay. So we already have given you the Manu Patra PDF. We are also giving you the print replica, which is the scanned journal copies from various journals. This may include Delhi Law Reporter, Bombay Law Reporter, Allahabad Weekly cases. So all these very much authoritative local brands are present with us. So these print replicas from these sources are also available in Manu Patra. Now, I'd like to ask you in the chat window, what is the relevance for this? Because we already have the Manu Patra PDF with you, but we are also providing you the scanned copies from this from these journals, from these local journals, authoritative journals are also present. So if we can, you can just give me an answer, why is it so important? So in the chat or in the Q&A. Okay, so Deepak sir has been active in this. Why are we providing the scanned journal copies? Okay. Zusa has said that as a ready reckoner, it is available. Okay, so that is absolutely correct. So we are providing it as a ready reckoner. So what that means is that if you want to have an option where you want to download the judgment in a local print format, so that option should also be available to you. Instead of going to the library, taking out the citation, taking out the print, we are providing you that option that you can always click here and click onto this one. This is Allahabad Weekly Cases. And from here, very easily, you will be able to get to the scanned copy of your local High Court journal. Okay, now I can download this here. I can print out from there. Again, Manu Patra is there. So coming from a brand, when you come down, the subscriber name will also be there. So scanned copies are also available. Scanned copies from various journals are available in Manu Patra. ILR of various states are available. Allahabad Weekly Cases, Delhi Law Reports. And Delhi Law Reporter is also there. So this you can access from this button, print replica. Let me show you another one. So this is ILR Kerala. So for the same judgment, we are providing you multiple sources. If you want to take out a printout from some other place, that is also available. This is Indian Law Reports, Kerala, and the head note is also there. This is the scanned copy, as you can see. You can take out it directly from printout from here. You need not go to the, these days specifically, it's very much not recommended. So everything is available to you at one place, even the scanned copies. Okay, so this is the print replica option that is available in the Manu Patra. Now coming to the third one, which is the Judis English copy. I'm sure that many of the attendees have joined us till now. So anyone familiar with Judis? So Judis Nordnik, does it ring a bell? Do you like, if you can just quickly reply to me on the chat option, like what is Judis Nordnik? And have you used it? Okay, so, okay, let me tell you what Judis.net is. So Judis is the website where you will be able to download the judgment. So this is the government website where Supreme Court and all the high courts upload judgment. So these are the court copies from different journals with different courts that get uploaded into this government website. So I've taken out a few printout for you from here. So let me open those. Okay, so this is, these all printouts from are from the Judis.net. So Bombay High Court, if you want to see. So this is the judgment from Judis, Bombay High Court, that you can, you'll be able to see from here. You can see the logo of the Bombay High Court from there. Similarly, Delhi High Court is also available with Judis. So Delhi High Court judgments are also available. Similarly, another one is the Supreme Court. So Supreme Court Judis copy is also I have downloaded. So you can take a look for yourself. This is how it looks from the directly from the website. Now the very, very important question is, I'll ask that question in poll. So let's go to the poll number two, launch polling. Okay, so this is the next question. are code copies of judgment, judgment uploaded in the website Judis, accepted in courts or printouts as a part of your submission? Okay, so many people have very strong opinions about this. So people are voting in fast. So the question here is, are code copies of judgments uploaded in Judis.net accepted by courts as printouts as part of your submission? Okay, so we have got approx 60% of you have already answered. So let me share the results. Okay, so 88% of you say that it is accepted in court, that it should be accepted in courts. And I think that is the scenario. So I'd like to bring in a legal perspective here. So Ms. Soumya Snehal, you'd like to contribute to this?
Yes, sir. So hello, everyone. To add to what Abhay sir just showed you and like as he told you, plus referring this judgment, as you can see on your screens, the courts have always, like, we have to understand that judiciary is, Indian judiciary is based on precedents. Okay, so any existing judgment carries a lot of weight in a court of law. Now, the authority of the judgment is very important. It is very important that the judgment has not been tampered with, because if you're referring a small part of the judgment, like, it can be tampered with, words can be changed. So for that, to ensure that courts, as you can read on your screen here, Bombay High Court in Ibrahim's Rasool versus Muhammad Zahir, Muhammad Sharif and others said that a copy of order passed by this court obtained from the official site, website of this court cannot be doubted, and the veracity of the same can be very well confirmed by the courts below by accessing their own official websites. So the idea is that the most authentic copies that you can submit would come from the courts themselves. That is what Bombay High Court was trying to say. So to ensure that users of Manupatra have access to that, we have provided this judis.nic.in option where you can access the exact copy of the judgment from the court. So there would be like no better copy to submit as part of your submissions in court or to show your lordships like in virtual hearings on your screen as it is.
Right. Thank you for that input, ma'am. Wasn't a particular district high court, a memo was also circulated that it should be accepted. Even there is a Chhattisgarh high court decision on this one. So
yes, sir. So if anyone is interested in like more authorities, they could like just write to me in the chat window and I'll share it, like all the authorities with them. So there are orders, there are judgments. Their courts have specifically said that this is what we prefer. In like circumstances where you cannot produce that and there can be like a miscarriage of justice, they might look at an alternative at that point, but you have to submit the original one. Like you cannot surpass that. So that is about it. Like this is the most authentic submission that you can make, and that is why for like Manupatra users, we provide this Judis one option.
Right. Thank you, ma'am. So let me show you the Judis copy that is available in Manupatra. So this is in the same judgment. This is the print replica. So Judis English option will also be there. So in all the Supreme Court judgments, all the High Court judgments, we ensure that, you know, you have the access to the source copy. So this is where the judgment has already, we have all taken this judgment from this particular website. So this is available to you. Because what's happening these days a lot is a lot of publishers are acting very smart. They are changing the paragraph numbers of these judgments, you know, due to commercial reasons or due to a competitive market. So they are changing the paragraph numbers. So this is creating a lot of confusion in the courts. So I'd like to ask you again here, we have a poll for you, say, which is the third poll. And so if some publisher is doing that, is it correct for publishers to merge or break paragraph in a judgment? Say, court reports a judgment with 35 paragraphs and the publisher changes, you know, it should be 39 or it should be 30 according to him, and he tampers with the judgment a little. So again, I'm getting like a lot of people are very much responding to this question very quickly. Okay. So more than 62% of you have already voted on this one. So let me stop this polling and share the results. So here you can see most of you, 84% of you have already said ki for this should not be accepted and this should not be valid because if you are taking a particular judgment to the court, the other party, other counsel is taking some other judgment and Judge Saab is referring to the court copy of the judgment. So this is creating like three different copies with three different paragraph numbers. This is creating a lot of confusion in the courtroom. So to avoid all of that, we ensure that, you know, if you have any confusion, if you have any doubts regarding paragraph numbers, or if you want to check for a spelling or anything that you want to provide a check for. So this is available to you. The Judas copy is always available to you for your quick reference, or if you want to check anything that is available to you. That's how we are ensuring a level of transparency with you also. That's how we are providing you the authoritative our source document directly. So this will be available from here, Judas copy, in any judgment. So whichever judgment that you open, this Judas copy will be available that you can click and you can, you know, if you have any doubts, you can check for yourself right from here. Okay. So these are the some of the print options. So we provide you many different options that you can, submit in court. So these are some of these options that I have already shown you. This is one new feature that we have recently introduced, which is the display setting feature. So this is a AAA. So just on the top left, if you click onto this one, now what display setting feature allows me to do is it gives me, I can change the font or I can change the format of the judgment or line spacing of the judgment. Say suppose I want it in a slightly higher font, so that I can do. I can change it whichever font I prefer, that I can do. I can always reduce the line spacing between the linings too. So that is all accessible from here. So sometimes, you know, you're just downloading the judgment that you want to read later. So you want to download it in a small font or with less spacing, or suppose you are giving it to a senior or some senior advocate. So you want to have a different format for that. So this is also available. So this is recently we have introduced, very, very helpful for any advocate, you know, to download this in different formats as is required by you, as is preferred by you. So this is from here, you can change the formatting of the judgment. Okay. So this is the display setting option that is available in Manupatra that can be accessed from here. Okay, so this is a AAA. So till now we have covered like the PDF format of the judgment. So this is the Manupatra PDF. We have also shown you the print replica. So different print replica options are also available. I've shown you the display feature. This Word formatting feature is also there, which is not for print, but if you want to are doing your drafting work. So this Word format is also available. So you can directly copy paste from there. In Manupatra, there is no problem in terms of copy pasting. So you can just select any paragraph. You can just Control C and Control V to the respective document. And we also provide you the Word format for this. So extremely, extremely helpful for any one who is doing his drafting. So this is again possible from here, the drafting option. Okay, let's move on to the next features, which is like, for the judgments, we provide you different options. What about different primary or secondary database? So this is, we cover notification circulars also. Let me show you where you can find the notification circulars in Manupatra. So this is the folder. So this is the central as well as state notifications we cover. We are the only one that are covering state notifications at the present moment. And central notifications are also very comprehensively covered. Okay, so this is, for different states, year-wise, we have, according to decades, we have categorized them. So easy to find. Let's do a poll at this point in time. Okay, so this is poll number 4, which is, which of the following ministries is responsible for GST related circulars? So this is okay. So I think most of you will get it correct, but there can be some confusion. Okay, so more than 46% of you have already answered. I'll wait for 10 seconds more to see. Okay, so let's stop here and let me share the results with you. So most of you have got it correct, which is 75%, which is the Ministry of Finance. So Ministry of Finance is the one who is responsible with the GST related circulars. Okay, so let's go to the Ministry of Finance and see for ourselves. So this is Ministry of Finance. You can see Manu Patra categorizes again different circulars. So this is the GST circular that we were talking about. Now this is the central, based on central tax. Just click onto this table of content and from here you will be able to get all the GST. So this is very recent, only 21st of September this particular notification has come. You can click here and you can access the notification circular very easily. And Manu Patra, as I've told you before, that we are comprehensively hyperlinked. So any section that has been mentioned in this one, say section 47. Now with section 47, so from the CGST, section 47, it will pull up. Or if section 148, or similarly, if some other notification circulars was mentioned in this one. So the idea is to give you the entire thing in one place. You don't have to run here to that website, found that notification there. So everything is provided to you in one place. Now here also we are providing you the source copy of the judgment. So this is the gazette copy. So Manu Patra is comprehensive, is very much subscribed in the various ministries and the corporates. So sometimes there is a requirement for the gazette copy of the judgment. So this is also provided from here. So you can just see for yourself. So this is if I want to take out a download, download this particular thing from here. If you want to print this from here, that I can do. All these options are available. Similarly, if you want to mail it to a colleague, you know, you are reading some judgment and you directly want to send this particular notification to your friend or your colleague, anyone, you can just click here, email this document, and you can just put in the email ID of the concerned person here. Okay. And just click on the send button. It will automatically go as the attachment. So you don't have to search in terms of, you don't have to download it, go to your Gmail and add this. So this is available in all the documents, this email button. Similarly, if you want to save it in manupatra.com, okay, so there are different, you can create this folder from here, or you can save it in some folder. Okay, so you can have a notification and create. Okay, so now I can save it here. This is the notification folder and save. Now, whenever next time I open Manu Patra, I have this, my saved documents here. So I can quickly go to that folder notification and this will always be waiting for me. So sometimes you're working in your office laptop or you're working in your college IP. So if you save this, this will be available to you from different places. Okay, so this is the gazette notification. So this is also available. So this is, let us go to our, let's do a quick review of what we have learned in this particular session, which is you can save, there are multiple options in Manu Patra to download a judgment or to save a judgment. PDF button is there. If you want to download the judgment in the PDF format, you will get the equivalent citations on the top. You will get name of your subscriber at the bottom. Print replica is available, where you will get the scanned copies from the different journals that are available in Manu Patra. So all the prestigious journals are available. So this is Judis English copy. So Judis, we also provide you the Judis.net copy, the code copy or the source copy for any judgments. is always available in Manupatra. So if you want to track for a paragraph, or if you have any query, you can go into that one. Display feature is also available. So if you want to change the formatting, or you know, you want to change the spacing of the particular paragraph or particular judgment, that you can do. Gadget copy is available for the notification circulars. So now let's, Soumya ma'am, let's open this for question and answers. If there are any queries in the chat box, you would like me to discuss or anything?
Yes, sir. So there were questions about display features. So if you could like please refer back to that screen.
Okay. Let's go back to our judgment. Put in my query from here, say right to information, and make my search. Within seconds, Manu search is very much fast, and within seconds you are able to find that or whichever judgments are relevant on right to information. So just open this one, and for the display feature, this is the button. So this is the display settings that are available here. You can click on to this one, and from here you will be able to download this as a PDF document, or you can change the display settings of this. So if you want to click on to this one, you can change the paragraph, the size of the font, you can change the format of the font, or you can change the lining. So if you want to change the spacing between the lining, so again, very much helpful if you want to change the different format settings of the judgment. So this is available from here, the display setting feature.
Yes, sir. So to refer to that, like there were questions about how to use them, like why are we providing the display settings, or like how can they best use this feature. So basically there are, like I would explain it for everyone. So for students, I guess the most important would be when they are going for MOOCs and they have to make their compendiums. So with law students, there is that if they are going for good MOOCs, they carry an entire luggage full of compendiums. A huge reason for that is that when we are downloading judgments, there is a specific format that it is downloaded in. So we cannot really adjust that. And that means that there are like A4 size sheets with a little text, which is in the international judgments, their format, or with Indian judgments, different high courts. So with this feature, what it allows you is to adjust them according to you. So the size that you want, the font that you want, the line spacing that you want. You could save space with that, or if there are like more important parts that you want to highlight, you can highlight those easily with that. Now again, with lawyers and with legal professionals and research, especially in knowledge management, now there is a very strong possibility that you want to keep certain judgments as part of your firm library or your personal library, or as part of knowledge sharing in the firm. So for that also, you do not need the specified code copy that you want to submit in the code. So again, for that, you can adjust it, the format settings, to your own desire, like what however you want. So I guess for these, like these two ways, it can be really helpful for people to use.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for that input. So this is how you can also use the display setting feature. So I'd like to encourage more of you. If you have any questions, if you have any doubts regarding this, so you can ask that in the Q&A box.
Yes, sir. So also regarding print replica, you could open that. So the option was that we have the PDF in print, then like why do we have print replica? So like if you could just revisit that very quickly once more, that one point.
Okay, so what print replica option, as I've already discussed, so this is, we are providing you a local source. So suppose you are working, going to Allahabad case, Allahabad High Court. And so this is Allahabad Weekly Case, is a very formidable local journal from there. So this print replica option is also available to you. The Manupatra PDF option is there, but you can also download if you want to go for a local journal. So that option is also available. You can directly take out a printout of that journal from here. So you need not go to the library and find the case from Allahabad Weekly Cases and take the printout. So that option we are giving to all our users. So this is the benefit of having the print replica from the local sources. Okay.
So Chintamani Dwari, he asked that how to get the details of advocates appearing most before one particular judge of a high court or supreme court. So like if we could just tell them about analytics in like one, two sentences, like that part.
Okay, fair enough. So this is we have a different webinar for this, but still, if sir has asked, so for a particular judge sir, there is this particular thing available, which is judge analytics. Now what we do in judge analytics is you can click on this button, and from here you will be able to see, like if you are reading a judgment and you want to, you know, do a little bit of research on the honorable judge sahab who has written this judgment. So this is one way to do it. So you can click here and you will be able to get to the different options that are available. So this is year wise judgment, subject wise, counsels that have been appearing in front of them, just cited. Once you, these are all hyperlinks. So once you flip this grid, so you can also see which are the judges that it is tending to cite the most. So that is also available from here. And the same option for judge analytics is also available from here. Say my home, click on legal analytics. So this is the advanced judge analytics. Okay, from here, so you can select whichever court that you want to select, Supreme Court, all the high courts. So this database is available in Manupatra, where a lot of people have asked this question that where do you get this data? So this is available in public platform, but we are using our resources as such where it's helpful to our users. Okay. So ma'am, any other questions that we have?
So there is this one that how do someone know the status of a particular case? So if for that you could just show them that SLP icon and whether it has been overruled or not. So if you could just tell them that.
Okay. So the status of a case is a two-way thing. So one is like if it has been challenged in Supreme Court, so we cover that. This is the status. So this is, there is one case in this search result, which is an image by Bharat Bhai versus state of Gujarat. In front of that, you can see that there is a icon available, which is the SLP pending icon. So somebody has filed an SLP on this court and it's still pending. Okay. And if you want to get the SLP number, so from here you will be able to figure out, you know, if SLP is pending or not. Once you open the judgment and you go on the top, so there will be this button of SLP. So click on to that one and do a little maths, and you will be able to get to the SLP number, which of the Supreme Court SLP number you will be able to get from here. The other way to answer that question is we have another product, which is Case Watch, which is to track the results. So if you have an ongoing case, so this is how you can track the status of that court. So this is the Case Watch. If you are using Manupatra, you will definitely like Case Watch too. So this is how you track your pending cases in district courts, high court, Supreme Court. We have a lot of tribunals. So this is your personal tracker that is also available here. Okay. So Soumya ma'am, any more questions that we have?
Yes, sir. There was this one question that if someone wants to search a particular judgment by a particular act or a rule, so like, can they do that?
Right. So this is going outside our domain, but I'll answer that one. So this is the legal search. So this is Manu search. In the legal search, if you're looking for on a particular section, if you're looking for the judgment, so this is available from here, say IPC, and you want to give it a say section 302. So from legal search, this act wise search is available here, and you can click on the button here, and from here you will be able to see all the judgments where IPC 302 is there. You can always sort them in terms of relevance, you can sort them in terms of decision date, you can sort them in terms of cited. Okay. Now I'd also like to point you to the our YouTube channel of Manupatra. So we have been uploading all these webinars that we have been doing. So you can just go to our this channel manupatra.com. So most of the features, most of the queries that you have. So we have separate, we have made different videos, how to search by a section, how to find through part, how do you mail this, what are the different analytical tools available in Manupatra. So that you can do, and you can come to our YouTube page, and from there you will be able to find a lot of relevant stuff. Okay.
Yes, so there was this question ki, if you could please again highlight all the parts that we cover, like our editorial team covers in the case note.
Okay, great. Open this segment. Okay, so this is the judgment. So this is number one is like everything our team gets hyperlinked. So any case that is being mentioned, we have a so many big team that sits where they hyperlink this, and subject category is given for to that case. So this particular case is a criminal case. Okay. Now acts that were referred in this case. So acts also you will be able to see from here. Cases, the list of the cases that were referred in this case, and the disposition of the case. So this is also available from here. So if it was in the favor of accused, or so these are the editorial announcements that is provided by my team. And similarly, if you just open, say, one judgment, say appointment of arbitrator, and okay, so once you open the judgment, you will also be able to see that this Manu instant thing that is there. So just arrow, click on to that one, and from here you will get a brief bird eye snapshot of the all the editorial announcements. So this is the subject of the decision, this is the citing reference. So of all the cases that were referred in this case, how many were discussed, how many was mentioned, how many were relied on. So this is again, it's being done by our editorial team. The acts that were used in this, the case note of this judgment you can read from here, and disposition also you are able to see from here. So these are in a brief bird eye view, you will be able to get the particular editorial enhancements. You can also see the prior history in these cases. So you know this case originally originated in Allahabad, so that kind of history also will be ratio descending, appeals dismissed. So this is, these are all done by our editorial team. Soumya ma'am, anything else do we need to take care of regarding this?
Sir, someone asked, Akash asked, what is toggle view?
Okay, so toggle view is available from here. Want to open this? So this will break your window in different windows. So if you want to work something, so if you want to open Word document here, or you know, you can simultaneously draft, that is available. So this will break your window into two parts from here. Toggle view is available from here.
So there are a lot of questions about case watch. So I have answered all of them in like the research-based queries. I referenced the YouTube channel that
We
we
can
have.
have another webinar on case watch, so that is also there. Let me just share with you one more link that you can ask, give us your feedback on. So from I'll share that in the chat window. You can give us a feedback if you are looking for, if this session was helpful, or if anything else that you want us to cover in the future. So I'm dropping that link in the chat box. So this is available, and again, I'm dropping this in the Q&A section also. So apart from this, the chat window, there is always this option where Manu Patra, you can reach out to us at contact@manupatra.com. So we are all very responsive there. Any query that you might have, any kind of feedback that you want to give to Manu Patra. So we are always available in the contact@manupatra.com. Also, there is this chat, this questionnaire link. that is available to you from there. Okay. So I think that is it from our side. So Devashish sir is asking for the features of CaseWatch and Manupatra in any manner. So sir, this is the website CaseWatch. You will be able to access it from here. So there are different features. We have will have a different session just for CaseWatch from here. From there, you will be able to see that.
Yes, I responded to him that like CaseWatch offers Manupatra integration. So if you're research, if you're an existing Manupatra user, you can on CaseWatch, so you could do that. So I hope he finds that helpful.
Right. Thank you, ma'am. Okay, so thank you, Chintamani ma'am. So thank you for your for coming to this particular webinar, and we hope to see you again in some other webinar. If you have any queries, any doubts in for this, or anything that you want to suggest to Manupatra, you can write to us at contact@manupatra.com. So thank you all of you. Thank you, Soumya ma'am, for co-attending this.
Thank you.